turtle barely glances at... The Great Forge is black with a soot of ancient work. Inside is a casting for an ornate handle, flecked with glittering bits of silver. Great Forge is...
Nice, I guess. Wonder what makes it useful.
Name.
spirit looks around with wild panic, clawing through its spectral mass with fevered nails.
The demon feeds! The demon feeds from the ring! The demon protects! We must know what the demon protects! The demon has an advocate! The advocate kills! The demon has a secret! We must know the secret!
The tree's spirit embraces its putrid host, an elven ancestor lost to the same demonic disease that infests all of Blood Moon Island.
Qui manducat omnio myrtus et, it quod potest esse.
Your hand passes through the spirit to rest against the corrupted ancestor. It is rough to the touch, save the pustules dotted across the barb. Yet there is nothing to divine but rough bark and swollen pustules. You cannot say which elf spirit inhabits this tree, or how it came to suffer its second death.
Nin ect me, elgo patidi ex ombre en mehre.
Does every corner of this place hide grim secrets?
The spirit of a man in priestly robes drifts from corpse to corpse, head bowed. He murmurs blessings over each of them.
Merciful Seven, smile upon your fallen servants. Brother Ashwell, Brother Triskel, Sister Revria, usher them forth to the Hall of Echoes.
He notices your presence.
Sorcerer, this island is nothing but death. You should leave.
The spirit utters a sigh. Even after having parted from his body, he retains a heavy heart.
This island was once a place of learning, of healing. Corrupt things have long stalked the fringes of our world. Demons. We sought to help those who fell prey to the foul beasts. One of our number, a doctor, brought an invalid before us. An elven maiden who had become infested with some presence. It was powerful. Too powerful. So we sealed it and the poor elf it inhabited in our deepest vaults. Sometimes incarceration was the best we could muster in such dire cases. But the doctor who found her was determined to make a name for himself. He attempted a cleansing ritual, but he only served to strengthen the demon's grasp over the elf. The demon possessed him. Soon the whole island was overrun with monstrosities and bathed in blood, our blood. It's a corrupt place now. No good thing has cause to be here. I am well versed in such things. I, my brothers and sisters, studied the wondrous, the arcane, the malignant. Easier to fight evil forces when you understand them. Our world abounds with demons and dark forces. Those who prey on the weak. They are a curse. But we were a scourge upon them.
He casts another rueful look over the mounds of dead.
No more. The statues guard the vaults where we kept those who were beyond help. No ritual could cleanse them of the dark forces that infested them, so we sealed them away. We did not use such cruelty lightly. There was no other choice. The statues guard the path. They will grant passage to those who sing from the hymn book, from the archives.
A spectral mass lies before you. Not one or two beings, but parts of several, slaughtered together, then left to rot without care or ritual. Disparate glimpses of pain and horror drift past you like a fever dream. A limb is rent from its socket, accompanied by a hollow, ghostly scream. A robed woman, a sage old dwarf, holds his own innards in his hands with bloody bemusement. Spirit of a black ring defiler swings her ghostly blade at invisible foes. She turns and shouts to unseen comrades. Her voice is a guttural snarl, ruined by the effects of death fog.
Go, find the druid. We need to find out what he knows. I'll hold these things off.
She turns back and cleaves her sword through the air. It makes contact with something. The echo of a bestial roar catches your ear.
Thank you.
How long? How can you bear it?
The spirit cocks his head and covers his ears, hoping to muffle screams that only he can hear.
The ancestor tree. The screams came to me on the wind. Though I am not sure the devil's breath that perturbs the air here can rightly be called wind. But they've been silenced. Well, yes. I have kept my ears to the ground, ghostly they may be. This is an archive, a library devoted to history and scholarship. There must be a record there of the elf that spawned the corrupted tree. I can't say where its entrance lays. The whispers that speak of the archive are all but drowned by my ancestors' grief. A druid. There are too few of us. Elfkind finds value in flesh where memory lingers. I collect memories, yes, but I am more keen on bark and leaf. On the living breeze, not the sleeping past.
Statue. Looking closer, you notice the statue's clerical garb. So simple, the hymn twines around winged keeper from stone.
Like a charm. Smell the blood and rot. No good has ever graced this place.
The spirit of a young, robed man paces the chamber anxiously. He sees you approach. A look of trepidation crosses his spectral features.
Did my order send you to cure the child? Some form of demon seized her and nested inside her mind. She cannot speak or move. We did what we could to help, but we could not risk provoking the beast within. We can find her here until a way to safely remove the demon can be found. It was my duty to watch over her, but I was never relieved of that duty. She has no family that we know of. All she had was a pet cat. That poor girl's life is drifting past her, thanks to that demon.
The spirit falters, momentarily lost for words. Finally, he musters a nod.
I was hungry and thirsty for days. Then I rested. When I woke up next to my corpse, I thought I was delirious. I hoped I was delirious. But eventually, I realized what had happened. Her cell is just over there. I can let you in, but... Are you sure you can help her? What are you going to do? Some of the best minds in Rivalon couldn't help this girl. And you think you can do better than they did. But nobody else is coming to help, are they? I'll let you in, but promise me one thing. Whatever happens.
The spirit can't help but smile.
I knew you had good in you. The moment I laid eyes on you. Come, I'll let you in. Take good care of her. Bring her somewhere peaceful. Don't disturb the demon within her. There's no telling what could happen if it breaks free.
priest has scried the demon's lies. The undead cat arches its back and hisses aggressively at your presence. The undead cat Girl lies still and silent in the center of the floor. Girl lies silently on the floor, eyes open and staring. Her only movement, her fingers seem to grip you ever so slightly. The girl's grip tightens. A flush of color spreads across her previously bloodless features. She's grown stronger, strong enough to move.
Take care of her.
priest has scried the demon's lies. The blazing blue flame seems the hymn twines a winged key from stone. The hymn twines around winged keeper, song doth bid you break from stone to dust, from stone to dust.
spotted something. So much history. I could get lost in these tomes.
Transparent artifact glimmers of its own accord. Your head
connected as one.
It's a crystal blade, seemingly separated from its hilt. You feel magic flowing through it, but it's vague and undirected. The object repeats the words it previously spoke. It has nothing more to offer.
The hilt of a blade, I do believe, but clearly no ordinary blade. I can feel my source power draining at the merest touch. Tenebrium is truly a... My lucky day! A third pyramid!
Weaver's spirit wheezes and... With his eyes closed in terror, he mutters to himself.
Seven, let the Void Walker not find me.
When they come again, they'll be stronger. I doubt we'll hold.
Please, I'm busy.
Sooner do I fix gear and the pally's ear break it again. Them Voidwoken have heads of stone. Still, I'd rather be fixing stuff than be lying there dead.
Thought Rivelon was flat.
nice try.
Almost got me that time.
I'm ready.
Greet the Reaper for me.
Is of no consequence, my...
Thanks once again, stranger. With your help, I might make a breakthrough yet. Well, let me see. You tried the Crimson Bream. I find somewhere that peddles ferocity herb mixes. Well, I might find...
Thank you.
place stinks, but some of these barrels look interesting.
Dripping with liquid sauce, this barrel is sealed and marked with a cross. Inside, you find not fish, but...
thanks once again, stranger. With your help, I might make a breakthrough yet. My findings are very promising, but speed isn't a virtue.
Anything. Watch your tongue. Sir Raymond himself gave me order to find the Tinkerer hiding in here, but I can still find time to haul you to a cell.
Well, if you do see anything out of place, report it immediately.
That lunatic is not going to take another Magister. It'll be a pleasure to watch Magister Raymond purge him.
The Magister looks at you.
You, but no one is meant to know about that. I don't know who you are, but leave me be and don't speak of this again.
A man, well-fed and wealthy, but stressed. He tries...
See here, I'm very busy. The factory is crawling with Magisters, and our shipments to Arx are held up. Time is...
He looks surprised. Might be faking.
What weapons? What basement?
He tries to look shocked. Fails. Knows it. Knows you know it, too.
Lohar. Lohar's smuggling weapons to Arx. He hides them in the basement, and I make sure they reach the destination. What they're used for and who uses them isn't my business. And it's not yours either.
He swallows, like he has a lump in his throat.
You look like the kind of person who's very forgetful with the right motivation. I have a sum of money in my pocket. It adds up to a very good time in the tavern. Fine. Take.
He turns back to his work. You turn to.
The tigers fly.
You rebuffed the kiss. There is no second chance, darling.
Mm-hmm.
Impressive? Impressive? Dare say the spirit of the one stronger in you than anyone else I've seen. Even Murgah.
Good riddance to Murgah. Her and her bloody pet Voidwoken had no business here.
Smoke billows from this strange contraption. It's adorned with hose. Spits three bloody teeth out onto the floor beside your...
I truly didn't think you'd have that much fight in you. I'll win my title back, I will.
Better not be giving Boss a hard time. Better get out there before Maldus makes it all the way past Arks.
Lohar takes the amulet and turns it over in his hand. He pockets...
What did you find in the cave? Dead, more dead, and Maldus. I owe you. Take this key. Necked it from the whites. It opens a chest. I guess there's no hiding it now. It's like this. When we found it, I didn't want Maldus. I'll go destroy the Death Fog Bomb myself.
In an instant, Lohar...
No! What have we done? Maldus had to go, so yell all you want. I'm gonna do what? There'll be a wedding in full swing by the time you... Arks, wedding, Mikhail Ross. Got that?
The battered dwarf pulls her lips back into a garish, open-mouthed grin.
Move along. long back, least I can...
Step off, lest you want...
It's not true.
Doesn't this room strike you as... But, of course, I should...
You know, when one's in a small town, have you a reason for barging into my room, sir? No harm done, nice still. I may as well introduce travels, you say. And why would you assume...
He laughs, huh?
Of all I go... That's as a merchant. It is quite my music. If there's anything else you need, please. If there's anything else you need, I'm a well... The merchant's burden, you see. He must escort his merchandise, always.
My lord, you want. I'm not in love with you.
To watch yourself, lad.
Your prayer.
Keep trying, my friend.
Animals argue.
Dog.
Oh, cat.
Dog.
Can't win, can I?
As you approach, the salamander turns its head away, twisting its snout into the air. It refuses to even look in your direction. Within the stone garden's walls, peace be thy immortal fortune. Relieved of toil, free of dignity, until thou art called to serve.
Ah, you again. Any luck in old Lady Surrey's tomb? Oh, goodness. Take a few... You again. Poor thing. Feeling your advancing age, are you? But no matter. Find the tomb where Joanna Surrey is buried. Retrieve the mysterious heirloom that was buried with
Tarquin's.
I hate to sound so condescending, but sometimes do enjoy yourself in the crypt.
always, if unwilling to whisk me away from this place.
The spirit's lips move rapidly, but you hear little be... This statue was once... Here lies Phelan Surrey, whose family's generous patronage helped build these burial grounds, and who refused to be buried in the Surrey crypt.
It's shut tight. It's shut tight.
Connected to some other mechanism.
Here lies Galen Heavendale, a lost soul, executed in his prime, aged 19. Great Forge is black. Thank you. Great Forge is black with a soot of ancient... The Great Forge is black... From stone to dust, from stone to the deeper part of the lock mechanism. A presence accosts you. You cannot see it, yet know it is there. It is, you hear its whispers. The master must teach you so that you may become a master in turn. And then it is gone.
It's not working. There's something to this I'm not seeing.
The spirit of a priest lifts his eyes to yours. When he speaks, he rasps as if there were dust in his voice.
I watch the gate. Who goes there? I watch the gate. I watch the one who must be watched. I watch the one who should be dead but can only be chained. I watch the gate. You must leave. The one who must be chained will take your soul. Do not let it speak. Do not let it speak to you. No. You must leave. You must not speak to it. You must not speak to the one who must be chained. It will steal your soul. It will steal your very soul. Do not let it speak. I beseech you, do not let it speak. The lock will work. The gate will open. I am the key. I am the gate.
From stone to dust, from stone to dust. A lizard on all fours lies chained in the pit. The raw power you sense within her is barely contained by the spell that binds her.
Do you know who you are, Godwoken? Do you know what you seek? I am you, but greater. I am Godwoken, born to be divine, all-powerful. So powerful the priests imprisoned me here. They feared me. And so they should. I am fearsome. And I am generous. I will grant my powers to the Godwoken who would use them for good. These are chains of pure source. Not even the divine, the gods rest his tortured soul, could break them. Set me free, and I shall give you the power that you seek. Not always, my friend, and not this time. Come. use me, untold power will be yours. Show me the goodness of your heart, God Woken, and I will share my power. Come.
The chains snake out towards you. They encircle you in a cold embrace. You wish to step towards her and at the same time wish to step away, but you cannot move at all.
I know who you are. I know what you want. And I do not care. All your power will be mine. I will eat your heart.
The pain as the source is torn from you is both agonizing and sublime, and then it is gone. When she speaks, the honey in her voice is gone. She speaks now as a demon.
Now you die. Teach your final lesson.
One who should be dead is dead. I'll watch the gate no more.
A trembling spirit wrings his hands, his eyes darting around the room. They settle on you.
What are you doing here? What do you want? You mustn't linger. You mustn't remain. There can be no reason. This is not a place for reason. My vigil is eternal.
His hand shake.
As a priest, I planned to... So I lied to the others. Better one soul damned. As the levers fixed, you could... I suppose the alternative is no better than trusting you. Go, do what you can.
How very, very long it's been. Would you believe Brother Calvin locked me up in here because he said I was possessed by a demon? Just because I don't feel pain. Have you ever heard anything so superstitious? Well, they didn't look like me, did they? Maybe I was a little kooky back then. But you'd be amazed how sobering millennia of imprisonment can be. Praise the Seven, right? Praise the Seven, that's all over.
His mouth twists in an ugly snarl as he stutters that last sentence, and a flicker of something unrecognizable yet malevolent flashes across his gaunt face.
You are here to free me, right?
The dwarf's face becomes calm, serene even. He looks into your eyes, tranquil as a baby lamb.
Well then, just destroy the pillars. Nothing to it, for one not wrapped in chain.
The dwarf's face changes, becomes softer somehow. He almost looks like a different person. When he speaks, his voice is quieter, more reserved.
Yes, please, release me from him. The pain, I can take it, but he can't.
The dwarf's face flickers and changes, becoming hot red and enraged.
What are you doing? Stop it! Stop it now! Stop it and destroy the pillars! You wouldn't leave me this bloody prison. This bloody body. Don't act like you're not here.
Is gone, taken at last by the wicked spirit that consumed him. A tragedy has happened today. A tragedy indeed. I have no more reason to keep my vigil. I failed him.
credit to Tiraka Quechirum Sin.
A moment passes, then you feel it. Clarity.
You speak my name. You know my torture. Please, don't judge me for the sickness my roots have spread. I can be free. My soul cleansed. The demon has gone, but I am still its slave. While it lives, I am bound by its shackles to this humble plane. Yet you awakened me from nightmare with a single utterance, my name. And I'm grateful for that. How amazing that a name can wield so much power. Remember this lesson when you leave Blood Moon Island. The demon blackens another land now. It possesses the very doctor that liberated it. Speak its name, however, and you expose it. You weaken it. You'll know him when you find him. A doctor that accommodates a demon doesn't see patients, only victims. Destroy it, and you free me to the Hall of Echoes. Destroy it, and my roots taint this isle no longer. Now come closer. I'll say the demon's name only once.
The spirit's voice is a harsh whisper.
Adramalik. Naivety, stupidity, call it what you want. I wished to put the source within me to good use, and demonology seemed as good a use as any. Silly me. Instead, I ended up hosting a damned archdemon. The roaring in my head. The craving for living flesh. Urges. Good gods, the urges to kill. To hurt. The stronger they became, the harder I fought. And at some point, I was just gone. Dead. But not dead. And then, away. On an isle I'd never been. Encircled by faces I'd never seen, watched by a man I'd never known. They called him Doctor. He shouted strange words, and the demon bellowed. Then, one by one, they fell. I watched my own hands slaughter them. I tried to resist, but I couldn't. And then a final roar, when the demon rushed away and into the only one still standing, the doctor. That was my last living memory. The demon may be gone, but its disease still infects my roots, birthing evil into the surrounding soil. While it lives, I am still its rotting servant. I've suffered. The Isle has suffered, but you can end it.
is this secret that is this wretched me? The demon feeds.
The demon protects. Chance.
She leaps up and grabs the...
Shh!
She cocks her black eye...
Thank you! I have some... something for you. Unless some other scratchily poker fa-
Did you expect a needle?
I'm busy. Distant.
Aren't you supposed to be off learning how to...
idea.
I'll be glad when we leave.
Kind has been dismembering and burning mine since time immemorial. I must admit, if you can find a bucket, show.
May Gareth always choose.
Shaggy dog keeps his...
You run away. Everyone here run away. All run from something. Like sticks.
Bulls?
I run away. Very bad man. I know. I can sniff good and bad. Like a bad. Bad man. So bad. I liked his house. Big garden of stones. Lots and lots of bones to dig. Good, tasty bones. But when I sniffed him, how he is for true, I ran.
He pulls a few tentative steps closer and sniffs all around you, nose wrinkling with concentration.
Some bad, most good. Good enough.
He bounds, the dog scurries away to sniff about the area. Hephaestus sits slumped in her chair. You notice that some of her scales...
What news? Can you channel enough source? Are you powerful enough to proceed? Blessed news. Now hurry. Gather the source you need from the fountain and perform the ritual again.
It's slumped.
What news? Can you channel... of course, my supplier. You can find more in the cloister woods to the northwest of Driftwood. Hardly a charming place, but it grows nowhere else. Blessed news!
It's slumped.
What news? Can you channel enough? Of course. You can find more in the cloister woods to the northwest. Then why, pray tell?
She offers you a...
I bid you fa... My hero, I'm grateful.
She offers you a great...
I bid you farewell.
is a dark thing to contemplate a demon's name. Perhaps you can shed light on the matter.
Jahan looks at you utterly flabbergasted, but soon an air of serenity descends upon him, that of a chess player overlooking the board.
Adramalik. You have to admire his cunning. To think that in his guise of Deva, he and I shared the finest wines in the realm. Stories of the women we have loved. Thank you, Godwoken. You have done me an unparalleled service, and you've quite humbled me at the same time. You must go your path, I mine, so that I may confront the archdemon in his lair, in the great city of Arx. Please accept this token of gratitude, and fare thee well.
Someone's already plucked this one.
Creature suddenly holds its.
God, what are you doing here?
His frantic.
My little axe!
Thank you. ancient altar to the Seven stands alone before you. Faint, comforting heat emanating from the stones themselves calls you forward. Gentle heat warms your hand. The stones appear to be just that. Apart from a few faded red stains across the topmost slab, nothing. The air stirs, as though a voice rises around you. Hurry. Suck the smoke deep into your lungs, your vision starts to swim and cloud. There is an intense pounding as the world fades away. You lose all sense of being grounded. As you approach, Ralik greets you with a salute, though his face is marred by a pained grimace.
My, my. How you positively brim with sauce. No wonder, after all the adventures you have had, all the things you've had to do. Oh, it's naught but a chill. Bit drafty in your soul, that's all. You should.
A sudden shudder jolts through his body so violently that he drops to his knees, stunned into silence. Sauce washes over him, a wave over a single flame, but unlike last time, it seems to have precious little effect. An ancient curse escapes from his lips, spoken so forcefully that for a brief moment, all light recedes into the webs of darkness.
I have told you before, The void is stronger than ever. But so are you. I can sense the expanse of source inside you. You are ready to learn the spell I've yearned to teach you. The spell you will need when we reach the Well of Ascension. I have given you eyes that see the source. Now I will give you the teeth to take it.
Malik smiles, and you notice for the first time two vampire-like fangs glistening beneath his upper lip. A gulf of magic envelops you, and you feel a sudden, insatiable hunger for source.
Go on. I'm here for you. Give in to your hunger. Yes. Relish in your lust for power, just like a god should. Go on. Devour me.
Spell tore through him like a spear through flesh. Rallik looks grimly happy, if haggard.
You speak the spell with brash ferocity, like I knew you would. My champion. Oh, do you still not see? Even though you are a god woken, destined to be a god. Let me tell you the one truth about what it means to be a god. It is to be the lion in a world of lambs. It is about power. And power is not given, it is taken. With your all-seeing eyes and your all-consuming teeth. You can see the souls of the dead. And now you can feed from them to your hungry heart's content. So feed. For you will starve until you finally feast upon the Well of Ascension. By all means, fast if you must, but your hunger will soon trump your all too delicate feelings. Your soul has become a vast enough expanse to house divinity. You are ready. We must hurry now. We must race toward the Well of Ascension, with all the determination of the eagle diving for its prey. Your prey lies on a far-off shore, at the heart of the Nameless Isle. It is a place no one can reach unless their soul becomes their compass.
He places a hand over your heart, and you suddenly feel it, an unmistakable pull in a new and distant direction.
The battle for divinity is about to begin in earnest. The other gods and their chosen will try to outflank us, just like we must outflank them.
But I will be with you. I will guide you, stand by you. I will watch as you drink from the wellspring and as its source surges into you.
The void will be overcome, and you will be the god of gods. The end is nigh. Don't fail us now. You.
You jolt back to the world, stumbling forward. Dark smoke surrounds you, hanging in the air like black fog. This feels wrong. The Meister's cry cuts through the haze. You look up just in time to see what steps out of the shadows.
Yeah.
reason you I die for Avalon. I just didn't expect it was going to be in a small basement. In Driftwood, of all places. At least now you know where to go. Excellent. Although she is immensely powerful, and she is, she may ask you to honor an old bargain that I had struck with her. Do not accept.
She glances at her body once more.
You need to go, Godwoken. But I have one last request. My last wish, as it were. I want a statue. Something modest. A simple piece of marble and gold on the steps of the cathedral, glaring out over Arx.
Meister Siva's shoulders slump, a tired, melancholic
group. I would have liked to see that city again. I know you have all the...
The Meister's spirit stares you down. The spirit of an elegant...
I am the Meister's Meister. No air fills my...
What?
The spirit of the apprentice vanishes.
Supposed to be off learning how to become the divine and whatnot. Well, of course, not everyone on the ship's manifest has returned, as you can see. Tarquin slunk off to Stone Garden, as I recall. The graveyard. Quite curious what got ready to set sail when you are, Your Holiness.
If it ain't Francis Philosopher. Again. Any luck in old... Oh, goodness. Take a few...
your advance, find the tomb where Joanna Surrey is buried. Retrieve the mysterious heirloom that was buried with her. Bring it to me.
Tarquin sighs.
I hate to enjoy yourself in the...
The spirit's lips move rapidly. Canna's spirit convulses.
This one. I think a different approach. What does that do? Maybe this one. That could have gone better. Maybe this one. Maybe this one. I think a different approach is in order. What does that do?
It's shut tight.
Something. Shame. All this wealth just been going to waste.
Thank you.
unusual, and like the artifact you found.
When as one, I am slayer of sin and the bane of the living.
The object repeats its cryptic remark. The oblong object.
So close.
Ah, you again.
He places his hand on the artifact, and it drones in the demonic tongue. When, as one, I am slayer of sin and the bane of the living, restore my twin, make me whole. The object continues. In archive of old, the blade resides, an isle of blood where demons abide.
It's true, then. Anathema within reach. Tell me, is this all there was? There weren't any other curios in there? Just remembered why I prefer to work alone. Very well. This is the hand grip of the fabled anathema, a sword capable of annihilating anyone, even a divine. Imagine it, holding in your hand a force that could wipe away sun and shadow. A sword of life and death, miracle and sin, a sword of atonement. I can restore Anathema to working condition, but this is only half of it. We still need the blade. How fortunate that the hilt has already told us where to find it. Blood Moon Island.
The object quivers as Tarquin nears it and hums a response. Connected as one, the past and present slain. Absolution and redemption await the one whose sins are many.
Oh, very good. Very, very, very good. This, my friend, is the key. Give me some time, and every deity in existence will tremble at the sight of you.
He holds out his hand expectantly.
Lovely. Now, if you'll excuse me, I must work.
Tarquin turns away.
Let me think. A sprinkling of skull dust, a vial of dog's drool, dried illweed, a few more odds and ends, and I can get back to the ship.
Flash with something. Anger, perhaps, or fear.
But never mind. You'd better focus on the task at hand.
She looks straight ahead, ignoring you.
Ready to set sail when you are, Your Holiness. Fantastic. Now, on to the interesting part.
After many adventures, the party finally reached the place where Godwoken go to become divine. But more surprises and difficult choices awaited.
Still, it's what's on the inside that counts, isn't that right? And this is the place you're meant to become a god. I can't help but wonder exactly what you intend to do with such a power. That's true, technically.
But do be wary of putting yourself first at the expense of others. Those who are mistreated tend not to bear their condition indefinitely. Remember that. You'll want to hurry now. Divinity is waiting, after all. I'm hardly an expert on the matter, but I'm smart enough to put two and two together. Where there is an ocean of source, there is a well for drawing from it. To rise to divinity, you probably need to take a gulp. Though I'm sure it won't be that simple. Excellent question. Normally, this place ought only to be known to Godwoken, but judging by the ships burning in the bay, there's been a breach, let's call it. Regardless of who's on the island, all that matters is who ascends. Make sure that's you. The strongest will survive and ascend.